All right, what is up everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Chris and today, I kind of know I'm in a different spot as I'm in my hotel bathroom here in Disney. As many of you have seen on Twitter, I'm at Disney and there's been some stuff that's happened with the Flyers. There's been some things that have been coming out as the off season is getting closer and the playoffs are kind of winding down. And I figured, you know what, I have some time here today because I didn't have any park tickets today. I kind of decided, you know, I did a podcast earlier with Amadeo, and I figured now, why not do a video, talk about some stuff. And there was a tweet that came out earlier this morning it was exactly at 8:55 this morning from Elliot Freeman, and he says here, a sign the offseason is really revving up as the Final Four chase the Stanley Cup. Carolina has given Dougie Hamilton permission to talk to other NHL teams, opens potential for a sign and trade. And then you put a reply under that says, the other thing this does allows Hamilton to see if the Hurricanes do make the best offer for him, potentially allowing for a return if he doesn't like what he sees out there. Very interesting maneuver by team and player. So I guess you can take that any way you'd like. I don't necessarily think that it's going to be anytime soon that Hamilton gets moved. I think Carolina would be foolish to lose him and not give him the proper deal. But we've seen that before with the Hurricanes and their management. We saw that with Aho a little bit, that Amadeo and Nate kind of talked about on the podcast, where Montreal ended up offsheeting and they had to sign him to a deal that they didn't really want to. I know Hamilton's a guy that a lot of people look at is, you know, he was drafted by Boston and stuff. Obviously, Boston being the original six team. Obviously the media is big there and, you know, clearly it didn't work out Boston and with Calgary, he didn't necessarily really fit in there either. And then Carolina is one of them smaller market teams. So it looks like he's having a good time. But then again, you really don't know. And he's 28, so he's going into his prime. And I think he's a great fit for any team. Obviously the Flyers with their needs, needing a top defenseman. I think that's a huge asset that they can get. And the Flyers have the pieces to get them. I think there's a lot of guys. Now, I think that's kind of the issue is where you run in and is what do you give up? Because, you know, there's also talk of Seth Jones and things like that. But, you know, I think if the Flyers are going to be doing anything, I think it's going to be more of what they did when they got Kevin Hayes. It's going to be they're going to trade something for the players' rights. They have the exclusive rights until free agency starts, and then they sign them. I think that's probably the best bet the Flyers are going to have because that might be the only option that they get because there are going to be a lot of teams that are going to be looking out there for guys like Hamilton, guys like Jones. And honestly, if they can't, then you still have those guys like Ekman Larson, like Ellison Ekholm from Nashville that you can still get. So I think the Flyers have a lot of things here. And I think, I said it before and I'll say it again, I think Seattle has a lot to do with this. So I wouldn't be surprised if the Flyers are kind of quiet until the expansion draft and then they kind of start to hear some rumblings and stuff of what the Flyers are going to be doing. But I know there have been some other things that the Flyers have done recently. Ian LaPerriere was hired as head coach at Lehigh Valley Phantoms. That's something me and Amadeo talked about for a really brief time on the pod. I personally love it. I think Lappy's one of them guys. He's been very good with the players. You see that all the time. He was you know, assistant coach for the Flyers since 2013-14 until this past season. So I've always liked Lappy. I think he's going to be great down in Lehigh Valley. And I think he's one of them guys where he expects a lot. I think they definitely did say that he's going to take some time to pick his staff. I don't think there's any rush. And I think that's kind of the same thing for the Flyers, you know, to fill in that other assistant coach. There's been talk that, you know, Sam Carcitti tweeted it not too long ago that Nick Schultz was one of the lead candidates. If you missed it, I did just do an interview with Nick Schultz not too long ago. Who he is one of the player development coaches now, but I did just do an interview with him not too long ago on that. But and obviously, if you want to check that out, you can. That was a great interview. And seriously, Nick, thank you for doing that. But you know, I think there's a lot of things the Flyers can do this offseason. I know the defense comes first, but I think the backup goaltender is another thing. They definitely could fill something in there. I don't think Elliott's going to be back. The Flyers also did sign Felix Sandstrom because you have to, you know, leave a goalie unprotected, and he's most likely going to be the goalie that's unprotected because obviously Carter Hart will be protected. But, you know, I think for the most part for the Flyers, I think the backup goaltender is probably the second thing that they need to go for. Obviously, the defense is first. And then after that, I think, honestly, a fourth-line center could be big. I know there's some people that think they might need a winger. I don't think so. I think they have enough wingers. I think they're actually loaded with prospects. And I think adding more is not necessarily what they really need to do, to be honest with you. And another thing that just came out about a half an hour ago, the Flyers re-signed forwards Grimmer Rupsov and Linus Sandin to both one-year two-way contracts. So both of them get re-signed. As for Sandin, he had a really good year with the Phantoms. There was no, I didn't see any reason why he wouldn't get re-signed. I thought he had a great year. And as for Rupsov, I know there's been a lot of people that don't necessarily think Rupsov is that great of a player. He's dealt with injuries. I don't necessarily think he's really had much of a chance besides the one game he got November 1st, 2019 against the Devils. That's it. So I think for the most part, I would like to see him get another chance. And I think, as I said, I think the Flyers have a lot of these guys that are kind of coming in here and things like that. So I don't know. I think there's a lot of stuff that's going to be coming with the Flyers soon. And I think we're getting a little taste now of what the offseason could be like, and how crazy it is, because I know a lot of people have been flipping out on Twitter and stuff. But seriously, I know it's been a while since I did a video, but thank you guys for the support. I know I haven't necessarily done that much, but I do have a lot of stuff planned. I have some draft stuff coming. I'm going to be doing some more stuff with the guys from Flyers Nitty Gritty. Me and Amadeo are still going to be doing the podcast and everything. So seriously, stay tuned for that. Remember, guys, podcast articles, those links are on my channel. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.